Okay, I hope the slides are visible to you. So today's topic
Yes,
of
sir.
discussion, today's topic of discussion are basically all our sharing bridges, right? But different configuration of sharing bridge, they are modified. First sharing bridge we have already studied, right? That was high voltage sharing bridge, wherein low voltage branches of the bridge were shielded for the measurement and safety purpose, and also to minimize the stray capacitances. Now sharing bridge, we are going to consider three different versions. Okay, so first version is with respect to the grounded capacitances, right? Second version is with respect to the insulators or objects being tested which draw high charging current, like cable and capacitor banks. And third one, sharing bridge used for measurement of high dissipation factor kind of apparatus that is to be tested, electrical apparatus. Because ultimately, we must realize that we are working on testing of electrical apparatus. So electrical apparatus can be in the form of grounded capacitance or bushings. They may be high power cables which draw high charging current. So when we want to test the cable, we have to connect it with the sharing bridge. And since it is drawing large charging current, there will be some changes made in the bridge circuit in order to accommodate this high charging current. Similarly, there may be some kind of capacitors or power cables which take high dissipation factor. Okay, they have high dissipation factor. So the range of the sharing bridge has to be extended in order to measure high dissipation factor or high level loss factor. Okay. So what are those changes and how they are implemented? But basically, these are all sharing bridge methods. Many times, when there is a question in the examination, you have to remember which type is asked. Because if you just remember sharing bridge, then there are four or five different versions. So you have to be careful with that while answering. Okay. So let us now move ahead to the next slide. So the learning objectives for this particular topic that we have just now started is to measure dielectric constant with respect to grounded capacitances. Okay, cable which are underground cables. Okay, and naturally the outer coating of that particular cable is at ground potential. So when such capacitances have to be tested for the cable, what method is adopted? Then measurement with respect to high charging currents. Again, cable and capacitor banks, they tend to draw high charging current. And then measurement with high dissipation factor. So three different versions of sharing bridge we are going to consider. So let us come up with the first type of configuration, right? That is a sharing bridge for grounded capacitance. Sharing bridge for the grounded capacitance. So you can consider that this particular sample, this is the unknown. This one is the unknown element that is to be measured, right? And it represents a grounded capacitance type of electrical apparatus. Okay, maybe a cable which is grounded, or maybe a transformer bushing which is mounted on the transformer tank and its flanges are connected to the ground. So that kind of arrangement. So this is a grounded capacitance. Naturally, so various methods are adopted in order to measure this kind of scenario, and minimizing the stray ground capacitance. Whenever the objects are connected to the ground, okay, and ground is very close to the terminal which is being measured, so it is observed that there is a possibility of ground capacitances getting formed when high voltage is applied to the test setup. So in such a case, what happens is that there are two different methods proposed. One is the inverted sharing bridge. Inverted sharing bridge. So you can say, why is it called inverted sharing bridge? You realize shortly that you can see this is a high voltage transformer. Okay. HT winding, this is the secondary power supply is given. Okay. So high voltage is being applied. And you can consider that here, the HT terminal, okay, the HT terminal here, it is placed inside the cage, Faraday cage. The cage similar to the one which is available in the high voltage lab in our practical lab that we have seen, cage. Okay. So all this complete setup, this branch, it is there inside the cage, and it is a high voltage terminal. Generally, if you remember in the previous sharing bridge, high voltage sharing bridge that we have studied, we realized that high voltage terminal was the above one and the lower voltage was connected to the ground. But in this case, it is an inverted bridge. This inverted bridge is adopted because the object being tested, it is very close to ground potential. Okay. Earlier it was connected to high voltage. Now, since its outer sheath or outer coating, it is very close to ground. Okay. It is grounded capacitance. That's why the potential near to the test sample has been grounded. This particular end of the bridge, okay, terminal A, it is grounded where the unknown capacitance is connected. The rest of the elements, right, they are placed inside the Faraday's cage. And when they are inside the Faraday's cage, naturally the variable elements, right, the variable elements like R4 and C3, these require operating remotely or maybe by using some sort of insulated arrangement, okay, a mechanism whereby a person standing outside the Faraday cage is able to control R4 and C3 in order to achieve the bridge balance, because inside the Faraday cage it is a high voltage circuit, right, and it requires protection. So person who is standing outside the cage with unknown capacitors mounted on the outside of the cage and outer terminal is grounded, such kind of measurement, bridge balance is achieved by manipulating resistance R4 and C3 remotely. Standing outside, a personnel will be standing outside the cage. Okay. And this is called inverted sharing bridge. This is because high voltage is inside the Faraday cage and ground is outside. In the previous bridge that we have seen, high voltage was the outside terminal and rest of the circuit was inside the Faraday cage. Okay. And that was grounded. So that is the difference between usual high voltage sharing bridge and the inverted sharing bridge. Okay. So let us observe the terminal close to the test sample CXRX, it is grounded, right? Then high voltage terminal is there inside the Faraday cage along with the other part of the circuitry, that is fixed ratio arms and variable ratio arms. This is the unknown capacitance for which we would like to find out capacitance and loss factor, or maybe dielectric constant and loss factor. The standard capacitance, which is used for balancing the bridge arms with respect to the unknown capacitance. Okay, so this is a sharing bridge. Let us check with the other version. I am going to the next slide. Please observe carefully. We are on the next slide. Okay, sharing bridge with grounded capacitance, and see that this is a detector and grounded. Different method here. Observe down at the bottom. This again, for measuring with respect to grounded capacitance, this is the second method proposed other than the inverted sharing bridge, detector and grounded. So observe what changes has occurred over here in terms of the bridge circuit. What we realize here is that since we are worried about grounded capacitance, okay, so all the factors which are contributing to additional or stray capacitance with respect to the ground terminal, okay, those will be measured first. So CGRG, this will be found out, right, with respect to various elements of the bridge. Ground capacitances, they will be determined by using a bridge balance condition first. Stray, these are all stray ground capacitances, maybe due to the connecting leads or maybe due to the transformer bushings, or due to the mounting of this particular bridge terminals, right? So ground capacitances will be evaluated. So for evaluating the grounded capacitances, you can observe detector and grounded. So this is a detector, null detector. One end of the detector, that is terminal E, it will be connected to ground, right? And this terminal is grounded because the unknown capacitance to be measured is connected between A and E. So terminal E will be grounded, fine. In the absence of the unknown capacitance, first we try to achieve the bridge balance by adjusting R4 and C3 and finding the ground capacitances. First, we find the stray ground capacitances present in the circuit due to this test assembly. Once these ground capacitances and corresponding loss factor is determined, then what we do is we connect the unknown sample here and then try to find out the effective capacitance and loss factor and then evaluate the unknown. Okay, so in this method, the effect of ground is being eliminated by considering detector end grounded. So you can see that one end of the detector is grounded instead of terminal A. So since this is grounded, it is possible to find out the stray ground capacitances in combination with unknown capacitance. Since we know that they are connected in parallel, so some of these two capacitances will be the resultant capacitance shown for the balance. And with a bit of mathematical calculation, it is possible to achieve Cx, Rx in terms of rest of the parameters. So let us check the various elements in this. So unknown capacitance, right? It's a grounded capacitance. Then this is a stray capacitance due to presence of ground, due to various elements of the bridge other than the unknown capacitance, right? This is the balancing capacitance C4. Okay, let us check with the circuit operation for the detector and grounded capacitance and inverted sharing bridge. Points we have discussed from the circuit diagram. Now we can check with the details here in terms of circuit operation. First thing is that grounded test objects are underground cables or bushings. Okay. So the example, what are grounded test objects which you would like to measure or test for their capacitance and loss factor? So they are basically underground cables or bushings, right? The bushings which are grounded to the transformer tank. So whenever you say what are grounded test objects, so you may be asked the question in the examination, explain the method of determining loss factor using suitable sharing bridge for the grounded test object or maybe underground cable like. Okay, so you have to be aware and suggest this method for the determination of unknown parameters. For safety of measurements, one of the detector terminals is grounded. Okay, there are two types of methods which are available as discussed. One is the inverted bridge, sharing inverted bridge, and the other one is detector terminal grounded. Both the circuits I have shown you just now. Two methods. Within this also there are two methods, inverted bridge and detector terminal grounded. Right. Now in inverted bridge arrangement, the bridge is located inside the Faraday cage. Okay, bridge was inside the Faraday cage. And standard capacitance is mounted on the outside on an insulated platform outside the cage. So this was the first circuit. Please remember, we are talking about the first circuit, inverted bridge arrangement, right? Okay. The bridge balancing elements are controlled using insulated isolating rods. Naturally, when high voltage ends and terminals are there inside the Faraday cage. So operation of such controllers has to be done from a distance and using insulated isolating rods. Door se thoda sa usko karna padega arrangement kyunki baki high voltage terminals are inside hai. Jo balancing bridges hai, wo the balancing part of the bridge, variable elements R4, this R3 and C4, they are inside the Faraday cage. Okay. We move to the next slide. So what happens that in grounded detector method, the null balance is obtained using two-step method. Jo second circuit dikhaya hai jisme ki grounded detector hai terminal E, detector ka ek end grounded hai, wahan pe kya method follow ho rahi, that we have to check what method it is there, right? First, without the test object, the balance is obtained to determine the stray capacitances of the circuit. Okay, without test object, that means without Cx, Rx, the balance is obtained to determine the stray capacitances of the circuit. So what are the elements that contribute to stray capacitance? That is high voltage terminal, transformer, then source, and then leads. These all contribute to the stray capacitances. Since these are all AC measurements, naturally the stray inductance and capacitance, they are playing vital roles. And capacitance of the test object becomes comparable to the capacitance which is formed by the some unknown objects or grounded objects nearby. Okay, so that is the reason why we are worried so much about the stray inductance and capacitance. It is comparable to the parameter being measured and corresponding loss factor. So without test object, first the balance is obtained, so that will give us the stray capacitances, and in the next step the test object is connected and new balance is obtained to determine the dielectric constant and loss factor of the specimen. ठीक है, पहले बिना टेस्ट सैंपल के स्ट्रे कैपेसिटेंस फाइंड आउट करेंगे, फिर विद टेस्ट सैंपल के इफेक्टिव कैपेसिटेंस फाइंड आउट करेंगे, ठीक है, एंड देन वी कैन फाइंड आउट द अननोन कैपेसिटेंस फ्रॉम द कैलकुलेशंस. बट द एक्यूरेसी ऑफ दिस मेथड इज लिमिटेड. ओके, इफ द ग्राउंड कैपेसिटेंस इज लार्ज एज कम्पेयर टू द टेस्ट कैपेसिटेंस. जैसे कि मैंने आपको बोला कि ये जो स्ट्रे कैपेसिटेंस है, ठीक है, वो ग्राउंड के साथ में जो बाकी सब टर्मिनल वो हाई वोल्टेज अप्लाई किया है आपने, दे विल फॉर्म स्ट्रे कैपेसिटेंस विद द नियरेस्ट ग्राउंड. इफ दैट कैपेसिटेंस बिकम्स कंपेरेबल, सो एक्यूरेसी ऑफ द मेथड विल बी लेस इफ ग्राउंड कैपेसिटेंस इज लार्ज कंपेयर टू द टेस्ट कैपेसिटेंस. अगर ग्राउंड कैपेसिटेंस जो है वो टेस्ट कैपेसिटेंस के कंपेरेबल रहता है, इन दैट केस the measurements will not be accurate. So utmost care has to be taken as far as the stray capacitances are concerned while carrying out this calculation. Kyunki ye puri methods kya hai, sabhi method mein hum do hi cheeze find out kar rahe hain, ek to capacitance find out kar rahe hain aur corresponding loss resistance, that is rx, we try to find out loss factor. Let us take with the bridge balance equations for the detector and grounded type of method, that is second method listed above. Okay, the second balance means in presence of unknown capacitance as well as in presence of the invisible ground capacitances, so effective will be Cx dash, right? Corresponding loss factor can be expressed as tan delta x equal to cx tan delta x cg tan delta g upon cx plus cg. This is for the parallel combination of cx and cg, we can derive this one, effective loss factor. But we are not interested in cx dash and c tan delta x dash, we are basically interested in cx and tan delta x. Okay, but from second balance condition we get the effective capacitance of unknown and ground. From that we also get the loss factor of unknown and ground. Now using this relationship we can arrive at the unknown capacitance as indicated here down below. We can see Cx can be expressed from here as equal to Cx double dash minus Cg, right? And similarly tan delta x can be calculated in terms of Cx double dash tan delta dash, so they are obtained here, and Cg tan delta g, this is obtained from the first balance condition without Cx in the circuit. Cg tan delta g, this is obtained from the first balance. This is second balance condition. First balance condition means that circuit consisting of only Cg, so it will give you Cg and tan delta g, and the fresh second balance will give you Cx dash tan delta x. You can substitute here. Okay, and Cx can be calculated from Cg dash Cx dash minus Cg. And substituting this Cx here, you can calculate tan delta x. So these equations, derivation of course is not expected that we should derive. Bridge you study at the second year level, directly you have to use these particular equations for arriving at the balance condition and using it for the purpose of measurement of unknown parameters. Let us come to the next method. Okay, that is the Schering's bridge for high charging current. मैंने आपको इस स्लाइड के शुरुआत में तीन मेथड्स बताए थे, राइट? फर्स्ट वन वॉज विद ग्राउंडेड कैपेसिटेंस, और ग्राउंडेड ऑब्जेक्ट्स, देन सेकंड इज नाउ दिस वन, ठीक है। और फर्स्ट वाले में ही दो सब मेथड्स थे, इन्वर्टेड विज एंड डिटेक्टर एंड टाइप ऑफ ग्राउंडिंग। दिस इज द सेकंड मेथड इन द लिस्ट ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक स्लाइड्स, दैट शेयरिंग ब्रिज फॉर हाई चार्जिंग करंट। ओके, सो दैट मीन्स वॉट एवर ऑब्जेक्ट इज बीइंग टेस्टेड, राइट, वॉट एवर ऑब्जेक्ट इज बीइंग टेस्टेड और द टेस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट, दिस इज ऑफ सच अ नेचर दैट इट ड्रॉज हाई चार्जिंग करंट वेन एवर वी कनेक्टेड टू सम पावर सोर्स, मे बी इन द मेन पावर सिस्टम नेटवर्क और इवन फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ टेस्टिंग, लाइक हियर वी वुड लाइक टू टेस्ट फाइंड आउट द कैपेसिटेंस इन आर एक्स, ई एक्स आर एक्स वी वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट। सो एज सुन एज वी एनर्जाइज दिस सर्किट इट ड्रॉज वेरी हाई करंट, एज सुन एज वी कनेक्ट दिस टू द सप्लाई इट ड्रॉज वेरी हाई करंट। सो वॉट विल बी द इफेक्ट ऑफ ड्रॉइंग वेरी हाई करंट बाय द टेस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट? The effect of drawing very high current by the test object is that the balance condition that is to be achieved on the basis of current flowing through these various branches will be affected. Okay, and it is observed that the current drawn by this particular branch, which is connected to this branch R4, right, and there is a detector getting connected in between. Generally, detector should have been connected here, but there is a modification done. Modification is in the form of use of shunt resistance. So why the shunt resistance is required? So reason is that the very high charging current may exceed the limit of resistance R4. Usual variable resistance R4, which is used for the purpose of balancing. Okay, if high charging current is being drawn by the sample, what will happen is that it may exceed the limit of current that can be handled by the balancing ratio arm resistance R4. Okay, R4, it may exceed the limit of resistance R4. Naturally, to protect R4, there is a shunt resistance connected and represented as RS. Okay, so that current does not exceed the limit, right? And at the same time, a small amount of minimum resistance R is connected in series with resistance R4, right? So when we adjust the value of R4, it draws only a very small amount of current when we are trying to achieve the balance, and rest of the current will be flowing through RS. This way, the high charging current drawn by the test sample will not affect the range of R4, and bridge can be extended for use with high charging current type of testing. Okay, so this is the basic principle of operation here. So this is unknown high charging current drawing type of test object, right? Then here you have some modification in terms of slider arm type of decade box or resistance, where we can adjust the value of R4, a resistance connected in series with R4 in order to provide protection for R4, and a shunt resistance for diverting the excess current, right? So this is again a sharing bridge, right? And the modification here in terms of shunt resistance across arm and connection of decade box to some intermediate value of resistance, right? This indicates that it is for high charging current type of test object. Let us go through the details of the circuit operation. Very similar test object like high power cables and power factor correction capacitors. So high power cables, right, and power factor correction capacitors. You can see power factor correction capacitors. These are the examples of objects which are going to draw very high amount of charging current. So these are supposed to have high capacitance that tend to draw large charging current. Okay, that tends to draw large charging current. So you have to understand during the time of testing. क्योंकि test करते समय उसको circuit में लगाना पड़ेगा. Current जो flow करेगा तभी तो bridge को balance कर सकते हैं. At that time it will get balanced. Naturally, the current that is drawn, if it is large, so it may go beyond the range of what R4 can handle. Naturally, this high charging current may exceed the rating of resistance R4, and the value of R4 may become so low that contact resistance and residual inductance cannot be neglected. So ऐसे ज्यादा करंट फ्लो होने से R4 का इम्पैक्ट काफी कम हो जाएगा, ठीक है, एंड इट्स इंडक्टेंस बिकम कंपेरेबल टू द वैल्यू ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस. जनरली दीज आर वायर वाउंड टाइप ऑफ रेजिस्टर्स, ओके, एंड कॉन्सिक्वेंटली देयर इंडक्टेंस इज देयर बट इट इज नेग्लेक्टेड बिकॉज इंडक्टेंस इज वेरी लेस एज कम्पेयर टू रेजिस्टेंस. बट इफ लार्ज करंट फ्लोज, इफ लार्ज करंट फ्लोज देन नेचुरली रेसिड्यूअल इंडक्टेंस कैनॉट बी नेग्लेक्टेड. हेंस द रेंज इज एक्सटेंडेड बाई यूजिंग एडिशनल शंट रेजिस्टेंस अक्रॉस R4. तो शंट रेजिस्टेंस यूज करते हैं R4 के अक्रॉस, एंड द ब्रिज बैलेंस कंडीशन कैन बी एक्सप्लेन. Bridge balance condition is represented here as Cx equal to C2R2, and then the ratio, of course, this is derived from the same Rx, R2 by R3 is equal to R1 by R4. So same condition for the ratio of bridge, Cx equal to C2R2, and then multiplied by this ratio, we can determine the unknown dielectric constant as Cx, and similarly we can find out the loss factor related to Rx as tan delta x equal to omega C3 R3 minus omega Cs R3, and then multiplied by the ratio. So these equations, these are quite helpful. Sometimes there may be numerical example based on these values. Two or three values will be given, then you have to calculate Cx and tan delta x based on the parameter specified in the example. Next, we come to the third method for this particular topic of discussion that we started just now, right? Schering's bridge for high dissipation factor. So please understand that we are talking about high dissipation factor. Third method. First was grounded capacitance, right? Then the second was high charging current, and third is high dissipation factor. Okay. So for high dissipation factor, again, there are two ranges of circuit that are used. One is for loss factor lying less than or equal to 1. If tan delta lies in range of 0 to 1, then this particular circuit shown here will be useful, wherein the unknown test object is connected here across arm AE, right? And variable elements will be R4 and either R3 or C3. Okay. So generally variable capacitance is adopted, but what happens is that the variable capacitance being very costly, so it is suggested that we connect R3 and C3 in series, and then consider R3 to be a variable decade box, and for achieving the balance of this arm. So once the balance is achieved with respect to standard capacitance, we can find out the unknown capacitance. Okay, these all elements are fixed. Variable elements are present in the arm BE and then BF, right? So let us take with the next circuit, almost similar principle of operation, achieving the null balance and modifying the circuit in order to compensate for the high dissipation factor. High dissipation factor means that the value of resistance will be such here, Rx will be such that a high loss takes place across this particular branch. So when the loss is more, naturally it has to be compensated. It will affect the current flowing in the balancing bridge arms. So let us check if the loss factor is between 0 to 1. This is the configuration. But when the loss factor increases above 1, there is a certain modification in the circuit in order to minimize the cost of variable capacitance. So let us check with that. It's an unknown capacitance, right? Then this is C3 parallel with R3 for testing tan delta less than equal to 1, right? We come to the next slide, and you can observe here that this is for tan delta greater than or equal to 1, okay? If loss factor is more, high dissipation factor, it is more. Then it is observed that keeping R3 parallel with C3 and varying C3 is a costly affair. So R3 is kept in series with T3, and variable elements are only resistances. So their cost is relatively less as compared to variable capacitance. And for easy bridge balance, the representation of test object is converted from series combination to parallel combination of CX and RX. For the purpose of easy calculation, the representation is CX in parallel with RX rather than CX RX in series, like in the earlier cases. Okay. So unknown capacitance representation in a parallel format, and variable ticket box resistance replacing variable capacitance for compensating tan delta greater than 1. Okay, this is a fixed capacitance C3. So let us go through the details of this particular circuit, namely range extension of series bridge to measure high dissipation factor can be done by connecting large variable capacitance across capacitance C3. Okay. Across capacitance C3, we have to connect variable capacitance, right? The cost and size of the decay box based variable capacitance is large. Cost and size of variable capacitance is large. So we must understand variable resistance is cheaper as compared to variable capacitance. This is costlier. Okay, so what are the alternatives? We don't want to use variable capacitance. What are the alternatives? So alternatives are that circuit 1 is used where fixed capacitor is added in series with R3, okay, right? And R3 consists of slide wire resistance in series with resistance decade box. Fixed capacitance is added in series with C3 and R3 is made variable. So this combination is applicable for tan delta equal to 1, less than or equal to 1. But for higher tan delta up to a value of 10, the parallel combination of R3 C3 is replaced by the series combination. Okay, parallel combination for higher range, series combination for the lower range. Also, test object represented by capacitance CX and RX, they are connected in parallel, gives much wider range of tan delta from 10 raised to minus 4 to 10. So CX or RX, okay, when they are represented in the parallel format, then the circuit will be able to give us tan delta measurements lying in the range of 10 raised to minus 4 to 10. It's very, very wide range, nearly of the order of 10 raised to 5. Okay. Very wide range of measurements can be carried out by this particular sharing bridge. Right. So let us summarize this particular topic. That is, a grounded test object like underground cable. Please remember carefully what we have studied in the three topics. It is getting summarized here for easy understanding. Grounded test object like underground cable, it can be tested using inverted sharing bridge or grounded detector method. Okay, so two methods, inverted sharing bridge and grounded detector method for underground objects, right, or grounded objects. For testing high value capacitances which are drawing high charging current, right, a shunt resistance is added in parallel with R4 for extending the range. Pahli method ka point hai first. Second method, high value capacitance, drawing high charging current. Okay, high charging current. For high charging current, what we are doing is, we connect shunt resistance across R4. It will extend the range. Okay. Next. For high dissipation based test object. Now third factor is high dissipation test object. Okay. The range extension is done by adding fixed capacitance in series with C3 and making R3 variable as a slide wire and decade box in series. Okay. So that one is applicable for tan delta less than 1. And all these modifications of sharing bridge will be covered, and more will be covered for the three terminal measurements at a later point. ठीक है? यहाँ पे आप ये देखना है कि इसके आगे all these modifications, okay, to form sharing bridge for three terminal measurements at a later stage. और बाद में ये कि हम देखेंगे कि ग्राउंड ग्राउंड इफेक्ट ऑन वेरियस टर्मिनल्स ऑफ द शेयरिंग ब्रिज विल ऑल्सो बी कंसिडर्ड थ्रू सम मॉडिफिकेशन एंड वैगनर अर्थ डिवाइस. सो दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर एट अ लेटर पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. ओके, सो वी जस्ट ऑलमोस्ट लाइक वी आर हाफ वे टू अवर डिस्कशन. इट इज नाउ 10:45. सो वॉट वी